International Partners.
Smoove and Turrell.
Für die ganze Vielfalt dieses schönen, reichen Lebens.
Ladies and Gentlemen!
It's Canny O'Clock, it's live and pre-recorded, all the way from the beautiful Portuguese city of Lisbon. It's your main man, Smoove.
Oi.
And his trusty little sidekick, Mr. John Turrell. This is the Northern Call Experience!
Good evening, everybody.
Well, hello.
Well, shall I tell you what I've done this week?
What?
Absolutely nothing. I've stared into the wall for the whole week and done absolutely nothing. Never left the house, never went to the toilet, never got washed, never changed my clothes.
Is that not a normal Smoove week, though?
No, I was fairly productive. I've made a couple of tracks this week. Even if they're not very good, I still tried.
Hey, I've heard them sound, and they've got the startings of something good.
Yeah, they haven't got the ending, though. That's where JT comes in, eh?
Oh, yeah.
And I don't think I've got any exclusives this week, have we? I should have
yes,
thought about
it.
Have you? Excellento. Tremendo!
It's only a minute and a half long, but it's a minute and a half of goodness.
Let's find out where we are then, John. Over here.
Lisbon of one of Europe's most soulful, captivating and picturesque capitals. Built on a series of hills and scenic vistas, from every angle, the city of oceans. The only European capital with sunsets on the sea. So close to sandy beaches and one of the world's largest state-of-the-art aquariums. Oh, I'm looking forward to that. One of the world's greatest natural harbors, which has attracted different civilizations. Now reflected in the architecture and culture, recalling the Phoenicians, the Celts, the Romans, the Visigoths, and the Moors. And to be honest, if you get them all in one photo, it's totally Instagrammable! Beautiful city, Lisbon.
It certainly is. We've been there a few times.
Can you remember when we missed a bird and we had to fly out to the Azores on the smallest aeroplane known to man?
Well, basically, it was so far to fly because obviously we've got to come from Newcastle first. So London, then to, I don't know where it was.
Newcastle.
Germany, and then.
Then to Lisbon.
Then to Lisbon, and then stay overnight and then fly the tiny six-man plane.
We got absolutely.
It was 6p.
Mortal.
6p a bottle, wasn't it?
Yeah.
In the Azores.
We missed a bird, we got mortal in Lisbon.
Oh, yeah.
And then we had to get up dead early to get on this flight. We just thought we were getting on a normal plane.
So the Azores is supposed to be a little island where it's central
right
of the world.
Right in the middle of the Atlantic.
So all of the leaders of the world meet there. I don't know whether Trump made it there, like. He certainly would be now.
No, he never got there. Anyway, this morning when we woke up, we're so hungover. And we got the airport, and all we seen was this six-seater plane. And the pilot turned round and went, "Just want a suite."
Prepare for takeoff!
Northern Call Experience, the greatest show in the world.
Kicking straight off with the mix, as always. Get your messages in. Let's see whose birthday it is. Somebody's 40 today, aren't they, John?
Yeah, someone is 40, but we're keeping it a secret later.
When the morning comes, we're out to see the sun. Hiding in the shade.
Real, it's not that real, until it's real.
Turrell.
Thank you.
You're listening to Nothing Called Experience with Smoove and Turrell.
There you have it, this week's mix in a mix.
What a mix, son.
All right, well, there was quite a lot of stuff that I got new last week, and I just thought I'd flip it up and play the B-sides for Benji B-side.
B-side bandit.
I started the show again with that superb band from Estonia called Lexol Dance Machine. And the album's called Explosion 2.
I love it.
John said there must be the first explosion somewhere. That track was called Entertainment. Absolutely love that. That's a great album. Look at that, man. Love you guys. I think I played after that.
Something else.
What did I play? It doesn't matter. I played Falk again. And this is from the EP I played last week, but this track was called...
a lot of people were asking what that was.
Well, I think it was Camille or Camille. Anyway, it's from the Whiskey EP, so if you want to get that. And it's on the great label Razor and Tape, specializing in edits. But that's their own stuff from Falk. Now, another track I played last week, Hypnotic, but this was the other mix by Revenge. Very, very simple version, but I love that. Lots of space. Not many vocals on the mix this week, was there?
I'm sure you'll make up for that.
Another track I played last week that I was raving about last week, the B-side again by Wolf, or it's just called Wolf by Medler. And a track I played a few weeks ago, the flip side, I actually played Bermuda when we weren't in Bermuda.
Nice one.
That was the other week. This week I have played Harvey Sutherland, a track called New Paradise.
Donald Sutherland's brother.
Yeah, so obviously the New Paradise is Lisbon where we are.
Yeah, of course. Yeah, the old paradise. Did you know that Lisbon is the second oldest capital in the whole of Europe?
Facts.
And the first oldest capital is Athens.
Another fact.
I don't feel like Steve watches the Steve right in the afternoon.
Obviously the sad news of Phil Asher dying. I played Let the Drums Speak. Got to dedicate that to my man Warren from Hoochie Coochie, who introduced me to that. He plays it every single set, or he used to, every time he used to DJ, by Bar Samba, and that is the Phil Asher remix, featuring actually the Fatback Band, and that's Bar Samba, Let the Drums Speak. What a tune. And then I played a Gam little naughty thing. You cold calls, what you got, which is basically Steely Dan, let's face it. John was enjoying that, and I'm sure a few of you out there were enjoying Steely Dan.
I love Steely Dan.
This in the background is another Gam thing I've just got, an album which I'm going to play some more of later, Rhythm Research Lab. It's a proper dub album, it's amazing. I've just spoke all over it. John, what's in your box?
One of my favourite bands, My Life, have just released some remixes of the tracks of the last album. And this is amazing. It's Automatic, but it's the... is it the Joan O'Marr remix? Yeah, it is. And just it's 7 minutes long, but I don't care.
Beautiful.
On the Drink with John Turrell.
Down. Reminds me of Cool Cut, something they would do.
It's My Life. I think they're from New Zealand and they haven't released a bad record yet. If you get a chance, go on iTunes or Spotify and check the stuff out. They're absolutely amazing. I'm sure Sandra, you know, I was into them first and then Sandra suddenly got into them. You know, that kind of thing. Sandra loves them now. But they are amazing and I want to spread the word about them because they're an amazing band.
Well, you've just done that. So, now, when it comes to bands, how many members do you need in a band?
One, if it's Prince.
Yeah, well, how about just two people, one guy playing the drums and one guy playing the sax?
This sounds terrific.
No, honestly, it's incredible how busy and how full this sounds, and that's all it is. Check this out.
It's not the guy in the supermarket, is it, who does Silent Whisper?
Ha ha ha. I'm a huge sucker for dub when it's mixed with hip-hop like that. I love it. Do a trip-hop vibe. I just imagine hearing that in a club in Manchester and flipping right out.
Oh, that little downstairs club.
Oh.
I never remember the name of that club, but it's one of my favourite old things.
Oh, well, we saw Morris Fulton.
Yes.
It was below. Ashley Beadle was
not
doing
Ashley Beadle done
the kitchen. I think it's called the kitchen, I think.
Something kitchen. What a night that was, though.
So
when Emma ate all your chicken.
That was great. Teen Wolf.
Teen Wolf.
our old manager was like eating, like, you know, we ate Ashley Beadle's food. It was great. Jerk chicken it was, with rice and cabbage and things. And then obviously we finished and there was loads of bones and little bits of skin.
I'm not a big eater as well.
No.
So like there was tiny bit of chicken.
Emma was just staring at it, wasn't she? And then she got stuck into it and I was like, check out Teen Wolf. Surprised she took the joke so well. Really bad that.
Ah, she was good crack, Emma.
She was good crack. She is good crack.
Yeah, it is. She's still alive.
I know.
She's got loads of plant shops. Actually, good advertisement space.
Exactly.
Plant shop, Stockport. Get there if you need some energy in your house from green plants.
Green plants.
Green plants.
It's the plant shop. Now here's a track that I used to kill back in the day when I used to DJ in Leicester. Unbelievable album this was. I forgot all about it.
And then you found it. Honestly, you've never seen a record covered in more crap.
I did have to clean it. It had half of Leicester on it.
I had to get me inhaler out.
Local newcomer and communications.
Mood indigo, in a sentimental mood. Mood indigo, just keeps running through my mind. Just an old refrain that keeps on running through my brain. It's blues, don't you know? Just another sad mistake I made. I couldn't wait for you, I had to keep pushing and asking. Don't you see, I thought you were the one for me. Blues always gets me in a sentimental mood. Blues always gets me in a sentimental mood.
Sentimental mood. Smoking drink.
It's got that Nicole Conte, is it? Is it Nicole Conte?
Yeah.
Kind of vibe.
You could say that wrong, couldn't you?
You couldn't. Not on the radio lips.
Hey, it's Marie's birthday today, I hear.
Apparently she's called Mariah now.
Mariah, Mary. Every time we used to just get our name wrong all
Happy
the time.
Birthday,
Mariah, Aqua Maria.
You're 40 today. Because everybody's 40 on this show, right?
Oh, yeah.
All the youngest members are all 40.
I reckon.
Aye. God knows how old the oldest member
is. Well, I'd hate to just put you burst your bubble there, can I? But Ella is listening tonight.
Ah. Is she 40?
Ella Broster. And she is only 20.
Well, double that.
40, yeah.
There you go.
I'll have three numbers from the top, one from the bottom.
And Bully's special prize! A gold tip vibrator from Butlins.
Obviously to dry your clothes on.
Only used once. Now, this song, I've just remembered it, inspired me to write a track that I did with Nick Pride on my debut album. Do you want to hear it?
I'd love to hear it, mate.
A complete rip.
I love a good rip. You are renowned for that back in the day.
Inspired, I'd like to say. Tony Locksmith's just hit us up and said he's just opened another bottle of slow-down vodka, the Smoove Turrell slow-down vodka. And I asked John, because he took it home, thankfully. I said, John, have you finished that bottle yet? And he's like, nah, man, drinking it slowly.
Very, very slowly, Tony. It's rocket fuel, that stuff.
It's a lovely bottle.
Lovely drink.
This is that game show that we played the other week. Crackers at!
Crackers,
we've got to make that a feature on the show. Have a ring in, you know what I mean? Have someone dial in and see if you can guess how many records I'm going to play in 1 minute.
You're going to love the radio speak I do for me box. It's class. I've got it all worked out in my head.
So yeah, this is Crackers At, and this is a track called Fly Away. I do like the name Crackers At. All right, then, before we get to that, let's do this.
Smoove is the one with the hair. Turrell is the one with the beard. Put them together and they'd look pretty weird.
They would. John, what's in your box? What's in your box today? John, what's in your box? What are you gonna play?
Well, I heard this girl. Well, yeah, I did. I heard this girl because she was on Sleaford Mod's newest album. I think she's on a track called Mork and Mindy, which is a brilliant tune. Her name's Billy No Mates. This track's called Heels, and she's just released this just recently. And I think she's going to be a really big artist in the industry.
Hot tips from Smoove and Turrell.
Check it out, mama!
I did not come dressed as you, you did not come dressed as me. Didn't anybody tell you we're in a state of emergency? I have nothing really left to say, I have no duty to be all smiles and nice. I do not do heels.
your head.
Now, I've got to say big thanks to Gareth. Whoops, what's happening here?
What you done?
Is that you or is it me?
That's shocking, that lake!
Got to say big thanks to Gareth. What's his second name again, who did your interview?
John.
Gareth John, not John Gareth.
No, it's Gareth John.
Gareth John, that's quite an unusual name, isn't it? Like two names in one.
Not really.
Anyway, thank you, Gareth.
I mean, my name's John Turrell, and that's two names in one.
Yeah, but imagine if it was
your names.
Imagine if it was Turrell John.
Your names, you've got so many of them. But Jonathan Watson, that's two names in one.
Yeah, you missed the Scott.
Oh, sorry. Well, John Christopher Turrell, that's three names in one.
Anyway, thank you, Gareth John, for the podcast interview that you did with John Turrell the other week, and it was quite insightful.
John Christopher Turrell,
with two brothers and a mum and dad.
Lovely mum and dad. I've got the best mum and dad in the world, on the planet.
And I thought I'd fish this out, because a lot of people after this album, obviously not at the time when it came out.
Now it's like Rockin' Horses Plop.
Yeah, well, I've only got one copy.
Yeah, so have I.
And I like this track, so I'm going to play this. And Mike Porter's favourite song, isn't it?
Yeah.
Wandering through the darkness, and my kid, it's a locking. Well, I stumbled and I fell across your floor. And the stale smell of tobacco and my aftershave and mingle clean knocked me out, not wanting anymore. Well, I drink 'cause I'm with me, and I get mad, I'm not supposed to win. When I raise my head, my eyes fit that in. Stupid, it's gone to me. Well, I smoke because I know it'll get me in. I may as well have these things I have, things that I call friends. And whoa, and whoa. It all is what I got. These lines, reflections of the lies, the tears, the fears I give away too easily. The alleyways and back roads to them all bring back memories, flashes of the good and bad memories that broke my heart. Across your floor, and the stale smell of tobacco and my aftershave and mingle clean knocked me out. I want it anymore. Hey, yeah, 'cause I drink 'cause I'm well mean, an argument I'm not supposed to win. When I raise my head, my eyes fit that in. Stupid is calling me. Well, I smoke because I know it'll get.
Getting some love on the comments tonight. JT on the vocals, and Nick Faber produced that one.
It was great to do the album with Nick. He's a great guy.
I think I recorded the vocals, if I'm right, on some of them on this
on
album.
Some of them, yeah.
I can't remember what I did. Not much.
Most of them were either done in a shed or under the stairs in his house.
Oh, great. Oh, is that the gig, the first gig you did with the Big Chill, and Mike took my keyboard and broke it for me?
Yeah.
Sounds about right. Thanks for that, Mike. Is Mikey P in the house tonight? Well, or is he too busy sledging?
Too busy throwing snowballs.
Is that the song that inspired you, the Day In, Day Out? That thing called Friends?
No, Day In, Day Out was driving to work, and it was on the...
On the road sign above you.
On the road sign above, but that one was originally written by the Stevies, me and Alan.
Yeah, that's right, aye. That's how I met John, because John came around my house to record a demo as the Stevies. None of them were called Stevie, by the way.
No.
Except me, apparently.
No, it's because when we first started getting demos done, we went to Tony Hutchinson's house. And his mate, Michael, who's a lovely kid. Now, like, he's one of my mates now, you know what I mean? He lives in New York. And we were that stoned at the time. Me and Alan, we could never remember his name. So I just used to call him Stevie. And
then
after about six months, right, he turned around and he went, "Yeah, lads, why do you call us Stevie all the time, right?" And Alan turned around and he went, after like puffing on a massive joint, he went, "Is that not your name, like?"
That is pure Only Fools and Horses in it. All right, Dave. Absolutely love that vocal. It's kind of haunting and lovely at the same time.
Beautiful.
Eddie Drennan and Do What You Gotta Do. From the album College. Or Collage, whichever you prefer. Is the E before the G or the E after the G? It's not on that, now. It's just...
Eddie College or Eddie Collage.
Exactly.
The E's after the G.
Is it?
Yeah.
Who knows?
From me.
Did he go to college to study collage?
Yeah.
In Cologne. Yeah, that's definitely a Benji B side. I know he'll be feeling that right now. Oh, I just read his comment there. This track is right up my rare groove street. I read your mind, mate. That's amazing. It does remind me of you and your... We used to have vinyl sessions in his room. I would take a load of records down. I think I'd be going to DJ in Sunderland, and I used to pop round his beforehand, and we'd exchange musical thoughts.
I loved how you didn't even speak to each other. You just exchanged thoughts.
Through music, yeah. But it was through the B-side. It was always the B-side. That was the rule. And it would always end on Marvin Gaye. on his part, obviously.
Why not? Because exactly. I would end on Marvin Gaye every time as well.
All right, then here's the remix, Pete Rock. This is from the Rare Tracks album and Searching Remix.
You're everything that I dream about, talk about, walk around and brag about, cause I don't give a damn about what they say, what he say or she say. I'm addicted like drugs to your loving, but hey, you got me strung like I'm young and it's crazy. You're making me nervous, I don't deserve this, I'm swayzy. I wish I could be, but you really got a hold on me with your sex appeal. I'm telling you how I feel, shit is real. Now I don't really wanna play myself, so I say to myself, self, get in grip and don't slip, cause I don't want you to think I'm some clown from out of town. I get down, I've been around, I ain't no hand-me-down. So you gotta show respect for me if you're checking for me. And don't sweat me, cause I really don't want no sweat on me. If you got it, good, flown it. You know what it takes when I'm searching.
I'm on searching to find the one and have fun.
I'm thirsty for your love, sugar, can I get a sip?
It's sex to five women that rank from 10 to 100.
You know what it takes and you know how I want it.
Do you like it?
Yeah.
Do you want it?
Yeah.
Well, if you got it, why not flaunt it?
Everybody knows you when they show you mad respect. You give me funny feelings with your $1 million step. Never quiet as kept, honey, always stay dipped. I'm thirsty for your love, sugar, can I get a sip? Or maybe just a taste in the place that make your face bend. And I would never try to kick it to your best friend. Or what's the deal, what's the haps, where we at now? Keeping it strong, moving along, I'm here to show you how. So all I wanna know is what you really wanna do. I try to flex, but sex ain't sex unless I'm sexing you. And I'll be swimming in some trim with the beachfront view. Cause all I wanna do was get next to you. So leave your crew so we can step into my hideaway, so I can step into it right away. If you got it, good, flown it. You know what it takes when I'm searching.
I'm on searching to find the one and have fun.
I'm thirsty for your love, sugar, can I get a sip?
Sex to five women that rank from 10 to 100.
You know what it takes and you know how I want it.
Do you like it?
Yeah.
Do you want it?
Yeah.
Well, if you got it, why not flaunt it?
You sit back and think I ain't saying nothing. You need to sit back and think about what I'm saying. Now we're laying my caramel crystal, so you can see the arrow fly before it leaves the pistol. Strong like Cupid, take it from a mobster. At night I crack her open just like a lobster. It's all sweet, baby. Now you know why I'm stressed when you act shady. Sometimes you chit-chat, now and then hide the cat. When all I wanna do is just flip that. But there's a side of me only you can see. Only you can, so believe in your man. I want you to love me in a special way. When I come home from getting kicked out the parlay. If you got it, good, flaunt it. You know what it takes when I'm searching.
Searching to find the one and have fun.
I'm thirsty for your love, sugar, can I get a sip?
Sex to five women that rank from 10 to 100.
You know what it takes and you know how I want it.
Do you like it?
Yeah.
Do you want it?
Yeah.
Well, if you got it, why not flaunt it?
Five slam from east to west, y'all.
Fresh, y'all.
Pound straight through your bubble vest, y'all.
Fresh,
and shake your chest, y'all.
Fresh,
y'all. Like Karamba, Sarang, gun clap a number. One on the set, man, I cut you like lumber. Still play the back in my thunder gear. Down to my underwear. Make all your mother's wonder where I come from. Cause dapper Dan. I'm a gun clapper fan. Plus I run rappers, man. Fat Five, Mad Live, blow up the spot. Drew High gets the paper. Black Moon still gets the prize.
Hey, yo, next to snap a neck, be big R.O.C. CK, send MCs to me in squads of three. Say rockin' this monster as he for really can be. See him in action as he transform that man's me. Enemies ain't caught him, ain't a welcome back in my home. Knots get blown like quarter slots and pay phones. Phone home or return like Jedi. I bet I can without lie give your stupid head a red eye.
You're listening to Great FM.
Come test the champion, you're gonna die tonight. And 6 feet deep is where you sleep. Eternally resting in peace, you felt relief. Now big up to all my true heads in the east. Stalking the block, not leaving the house without they gas. You best to believe that Fat Five got my back.
Like that. Yes, y'all.
Yes, y'all.
OGC, help the skelter be the best, y'all.
Best, y'all.
Five,
slam from east to west, y'all. Sound pound straight through your bubble vest, y'all. And shake your chest, y'all.
I control the masses with metaphors that's massive. Don't ask if the rucker bash it like ashes. I'm drastic when it comes to verbs, I be flipping. Cause herbs just be shitting off the words I be kicking. I scold you, double headed sword for the penny. But I told you, is that heads ain't ready. Now I mold you back to the that you are. And with the ruckus, get bruised, battered, and scarred.
Guess who? Pump, chump, your brain just blew. Blah. It's the original gun clapper, too. What? Rushing through, 3-on-3, you can't see we, cause we stay tight and not too many minions wanna fight. So sneak a whip, in the cypher of the camp, just got amping, so I took him out for a dance. Bigger triggers falling down, like the bridges of London, but ain't too many ninnies running.
Yes, yes, y'all. Yes, see how the skelter be the best, y'all. 5-5 slam from east to west, y'all. Sound pound straight through your bubble vest, y'all. Your chest, y'all. Ayo, why did I need cappuccino? Scar on my face, but I'm not Al Pacino.
What, three amigos?
Sparsky and Dutch with ring, more drama than what?
A primetime NBC TV show. Heads don't know when damn show ain't ready.
Nah.
Walk the streets with more boot than Betty.
Get heavy.
Back up, retreat, now surrender. My pawn hit your mind, mixed thoughts just like a blender. Nah.
It's a shame how these MCs are wannabes. Front on knees and get hung up like dungarees.
Please.
Ease off, select, I strangle, wreck ya. Plus bust asses on whoever passes through my sector.
So what you gonna do when you're stuck at 32? Degrees, please, get off your knees and follow these.
Now swallow these.
Buck shots from the rifle, then I will.
So that was Pete Rock before that. I'm spitting all over the mic.
Oh,
and Helter Skelter.
COVID friendly.
Yeah, exactly. COVID FM. Helter Skelter and Gun Clappers. What a tune.
Incredible.
Le Fleur, Le Fly.
They call me Sire.
I remember when I first heard that, I think it was on Westwood. I was just like proper,
off
like,
the
oh
rack.
My god. Yeah. Press record on the tape player.
Oh yeah. Like, sitting like an eagle.
With a pause button. Yeah. I got it.
Clunk.
Westwood. Alright then, so it's about that time of the night.
The
time of the month, as I like to say.
First time of the night.
First time of the night.
Because I'm giving Sandra 2 slots.
Oh, like, before we do that, check this out.
Sandra DePaul, Sandra DePaul. Sandra DePaul, Sandra DePaul. You got your Sandra DePaul, Sandra DePaul, Sandra DePaul. Sandra DePaul!
Please note that all phone calls will be recorded for training purposes.
Thank you, Tony, for that. I thought you'd like that, John.
Tony, that's a legend. That
I've had that one in the bank for a while. I thought I'd just save it for now.
Well, this is from a good friend of ours, Jordan Miller, who's one part of Vanderbilt.
Yes.
But what he's been doing is just Raj songs on the internet, some dancing with his cat, some. But this time he got his mate in, Luke Elgi, to do some bass with him.
Bubba bass.
And look at Luke, if I've said your second name wrong, well, please forgive us.
How do you say it? Say it really
well,
slowly.
Well, it could be Elgi, it could be Elgi, it could be Elgi. Elgie.
Elgi.
So I'm going with Elgi.
Before you do that, let's do this.
Her name is Sandra, she does the admin. She likes music a lot, so they've given her a slot. They've called it Sandra's Slot. They've called it Sandra's Slot.
Well, he has the track.
Sounds great.
Well, that's because, you know what happened?
What happened then, John?
No, something happened.
Sandra DePaul.
You were fannying on with that.
Her name is Sandra.
Things.
Yeah.
That, it went off. It's that short of a track.
Oh, it's
only a minute and a bit long.
Sandra's going to get sacked for that. The shortest song ever made.
can't believe that's finished already. Sandra, you're sacked!
You're definitely sacked again! So if you don't know, that's Jordan from Vanderbilt.
Jordan Miller?
Jordan Miller. Schmiller.
Schmiller! Incredibly talented musician. Unbelievable.
Speaking of intelligent, talented people, here's Brick Estra.
He's not intelligent, he's thick ass. come on.
coming from the horse.
I've been hiding from your eyes and staying out of reach, trying not to let my heart keep reminding me what I wished I'd shown you, girl, when you were close enough to me. If I don't get another chance, at least I'll have my peace. I've been hiding, yeah, I've been hiding, hey, hey. I've been hiding from your words and keeping my head clear, trying not to let my heart, oh, drown under the pain. I've been hiding, yeah, I've been hiding, yeah, I've been hiding, but I ain't gonna hide no.
Band that started out as a cover band, and then they made this album called Hit the Floor. Brick Estra, so well produced.
Underneath these eyes, and I'm hoping you will see what a fool looks like pretending that his love is not a dream that's waiting to be won. Or finally put to sleep, I can live in this world between what I want, what I need. I've been hiding.
A track called Hiding, and that is Miles. Miles Tackett singing, and his, and obviously his lyrics. Now, the great thing about this track was I saw them perform this live at the Sage, and I was totally blown away. One of the greatest bands I've ever seen live. The band was super tight, they were super nice, they were great with the audience, you know, that interaction that you need. But more so, the drummer.
I just like giving the audience, like, nah, telling them half off.
Exactly. Shut up, man.
Who the hell are you? You're not paying for tickets to come and see me. You're not, man, you're awesome.
Talking all hours when I'm singing. Anyway, the drummer blew my mind because the drummer, I think, live was Pete the Buzzard. And I remember watching him drum and he literally did that drum break. Right? But it was the funky drummer. But he was doing it, he was chopping it like hell. And the wood, he was hitting the rim shots every time at the same time as the snare. And the wood was flying all over from his sticks. He had that many sticks because he was hitting it so hard. And I was just like, man, the sound guy's going to be hating that.
Yeah, but the drummer was loving it.
Honestly, it's the greatest drummer I've ever seen live. So hats off
apart
to Brick
Estra.
Oscar
Castillo, Lloyd.
Apart from. Right, Johnny, it's your box again. What you got?
This is a great track. It's Little Dragon with Moses Sumney.
When is it never not a great track?
Well, it's a great track. Just check it out. My man. Thank you.
understand what I'm doing. Don't understand where we're going. Please understand where I'm coming from. Understand that it's all in me, but not plain to see. Please understand that we're strong.
Epic that leg.
Well, both Moses Sumney and Little Dragon have got amazing voices. So.
I suppose it would be in a slightly different light though if it was, you know, in a little coffee shop and someone was hitting a little tombola and they were singing.
Nah, I think both of their voices could hit a tiny little tombola and still be brilliant.
Pull it off.
Yeah, you're right.
Now, here's an obvious one. Well, I haven't played this for so many years. This is Roy Ayres, and it's an incredible song he wrote called Can't You See Me. Sending this one out for Toby Kift. Is he in the house tonight?
Can't you see me? Wait, he's in the house?
Oh,
geezer funk.
I've been loving watching his little videos he's been putting up of his 12 inches, just playing them and dancing in his own room, but not showing himself dancing, though. Now, that would be different. He's probably naked while he's doing it, though.
He has got 12 inches, has he?
Oh, aye, 13 inch.
We'll be right back. Corn Spirit is the greatest show in the world.
Turrell, Angels of the North.
So we just had a call, an urgent call from Kev Cook, who said, where's Johnny Gaga gone? That's a good question.
It's funny enough, I just got back from Coachella last weekend, and can I just tell you, I was there with one of my greatest mates, Sandra. She was showing me all the new music that was coming out, and I was like, "Dad, that's not EDM, it's something even more sexy." But I was sort of like, oh, she was sort of like, ah, and the two of us got together, and we just performed great oral amazement together.
Now, Johnny, somebody told me that you've moved on and you've got, you've discovered a new music. Is that right?
I discover a lot of new music all the time, and sometimes I like just chilling, but other times I like to freak out. And this is something that me and Sandra were talking about, more like freak out music, you know? So he gave me this track, or she gave me this track. I can never tell. I live in such a world. It's men are women, women are men. Everyone's the same. We're androgynous motherfuckers. So anyway, he gave me this track, she gave me this track, and I just love it. It's Dragon Rush by Alone.
Sounds great, Johnny.
Yeah, it's super duper.
What else has been happening in Johnny then? What's been going on in your world? You've been traveling much?
I still travel because there's still parties that need to happen, even in COVID times.
But how do you travel?
I mean, look at Rita Ora. I done her little party.
All right, okay.
And she got done, but I was out of there. I was in a limousine. I was back at the Sheraton in about 2 seconds.
And how do you actually travel? Because nobody seems to be able to travel these days. How do you manage to do it?
These days, mostly by Bentley, but it used to be Rolls Royce.
Across the sea and stuff.
Oh, no. Private jet.
Learjet. Of course.
I only fly Learjet.
Do you fly yourself?
I'm one of the world's most expensive musicians. Well, I call myself a musician. I don't play one single instrument. I DJ mostly, you know, EDM.
That's an instrument though, isn't it, surely?
No, that's for sad fuckers.
I have to reverse these words later on.
I'm so sorry. I just get so just into it, you know?
I know. Understandable.
It's because I live the high life.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is Johnny Gaga. You're listening to the Northern Call Experience with Smoove and Turrell. Where is Turrell gone, actually? I think he's got the toilet.
No. I'm back.
Oh, there you are.
Gaga's just gotten the Bentley and just
zipped
done
off.
One.
Right. Nice to speak to Johnny.
Really got to tell him not to swear so much when he's on the radio.
See you later, Johnny.
See you later, guys.
There he goes. Right, so what are we doing? We're doing another Sandra slot because she's got two this week. The greedy...
Back and front.
Whoosh! Get a load of that. It's infectious, Johnny's voice, isn't it? So dramatic.
sachet away.
I think if we did a whole show in his voice, it would be like, I think we'd lose everyone. Or maybe we'll gain more listeners.
Yeah, totally. One of the biggest DJs in the world, mate.
The biggest undiscovered DJs in the world.
EDM, you know what I mean? He's top of the pops.
I thought it was MDE he does.
No, not MDMA.
No, MDE. Murdering dance floors, baby.
Gotta get yourself a glove.
MDF.
DJ.
Murder on the dance floor.
Gotta burn this goddamn house right down.
Oh, Sophie Ellis' back seat is in the house.
Not actually, I was just singing later.
All right, okay. I thought I saw her run past there with a skirt on. Right, come on, there's Sandra's slot. Hang on, let's do another one of these. Hang on.
This is John's box.
Yeah, it's not that, is it? No, let's not do that.
Come on, man.
I'm going to have to wait till that.
I think having Johnny Gaga on here is through you.
It's totally through us. Well, let's see if this works instead.
Her name is Sandra. She does the admin.
Not anymore, she's fired.
She likes music a lot, so they've given her a slot. They've called it Sandra's slot. They've called it Sandra's slot.
As Johnny Gaga just explained, this is Dragon Rush with Lone.
I love that noise. Pretend hoovering up.
As per usual, those who are listening on the radio, we're going to have to say goodbye, farewell, bon voyage. But for those who are watching on Facebook Live, you got another hour!
And the rest.
We like to call it the power 3 hours.
Power snooze. With the booze.
Thanks very much for listening, everyone on the radio. It's been a pleasure. This is the Northern Coal Experience with Smoove and Turrell. And it was beautiful to have Johnny Gargo in tonight.
It's all right. Remember in the old days when you used to go to clubs and you'd hear a song and you'd think that we had a massive long intro? You just stand on the dance floor going,
how much time?
How much time is a long time?
Talking loud, my man!
Is a long time. I love this remix, man.
Remember them days of clubs.
Oh. Check for check for check for check.
It's
for
a
check.
Long time.
Check for check. Man, hand the move. It might rain and it might not. Out of the way, so we have it, get militant. 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 We have it, get militant.
Turn a corner. You gotta turn away.
Might rain and it might not. Galliano, man.
What a band.
What a remix.
That's remember shopping in Flip for the best ever 1970s corduroy.
Shopping in Flip.
The biggest collars, you know, just to go out in the town. What a shop Flip was at the time.
Amazing, amazing. I used to buy my dungarees from there.
Weren't as cool as these Nathan Claiborne's though.
Cut them off, right?
What, so and they had tiny legs?
No. Cut the top off and then put a belt through it and then wear them as jeans with the biggest jeans known to man.
Oh,
that was my little trick. Everyone said, white. Where'd you get your drink? No. Where'd you get your jeans? I'd be like, hey, not telling you.
That's an absolute factory secret.
Factory secret.
Secret from the factory.
Check. And we march on!
Now here's a classic. Eddie Russ. This is worth a few pennies.
Stars in the northern sky.
Thank you.
It's that time of the evening. It's 9 o'clock.
Come on, folks, you know now, right, that 1 o'clock is always late. It's got to be late. That's the whole idea. It's like, what time is it? Oh, it's 1 o'clock, is it? D-I-S-C-O, disco ball of wine. Supplied by Catherine Turrell, as always. 1 o'clock! Low rail. For God's sake, man. That was Lorel.
The Wayne's only been out for 2 seconds.
He's really famous for the Massive Attack sample, which gets hammered all the time. I didn't want to play that. You know, Mellow Mellow, right on.
Right on.
I thought I wouldn't play that. I thought I'd play another song called Overdose. Now, this is the song I promised you last week I was going to play this week. Which is Truby. You know Raina Truby from Truby Trio?
Yes.
It's the song he's done with Con. Very, very nice.
Let me get
just after the hour of 10 o'clock. It's 9 o'clock. It's where everything starts to go pear-shaped right now. We are officially off the air as far as radio goes, so anything can happen now.
We're officially on the air.
Yes. In the air, as Phil Collins would once say. I had a really... I mean, we all have weird dreams, right? What is the weirdest dream that you've had recently? I mean, I think COVID's probably given people nightmares, to be honest. But I had two weird dreams, one which I can't speak of because it was quite sexual. I won't talk about that.
I'm not even going to laugh at that because you're the most sexual person I've ever met in my life. It sort of scares us.
So the other dream is the recurring dream. I've mentioned this on the show before. You know what I'm going to say? It's the dream where I'm trying to get to the airport and get on the flight and everything goes wrong. It's horrible. It's the worst feeling. And I wake up literally sweating and it's like so frustrating because everyone around me in the dream is just so, yeah, whatever. Yeah, whatever. And I'm like, look, we need to get to the airport. I've lost my passport!
Can you remember when Lloyd Croft left his drums?
Oh, left his drum. This is a great
and
one.
And then, you tell his story.
We got dropped off in, I think we got the van down to Manchester. We got dropped off to get the flight from Manchester because it was cheaper on Ryanair, clearly. And obviously we had some equipment with us, you know, like guitars and cymbals and bits like that. But the promoter would provide like the big stuff like bass amps and drums and stuff. So all Lloyd had to carry, right, was his cymbals, which are rather heavy, to say the least. And anyway, we stopped at the shop, went into the checked in, and then like we hadn't even got to the main part yet, had we? And
No,
we hadn't even checked
in. We're all rushing to get to the
right.
Rushing to get to the gate because the gate was going to close, and then we wouldn't be able to do the gig. It was one of them days where everything went wrong.
Oh no, that's another story. Anyway, Lloyd turned around and went, "Hey lads, which one of you has got my really heavy cymbals?" Why would we be carrying these heavy cymbals?
I'm a singer, mate. I don't carry nothing.
I like the way he said really... Oh, he didn't say that. Clearly he didn't.
No, but he did.
He might as well have said my really, really extremely heavy cymbals.
Nah, he didn't. He just went, "Yeah, lads, who's got me cymbals?"
And then ran off like the fastest thing I've ever seen.
Like a bat out of hell, wasn't he?
Like a greyhound going the wrong way. It was brilliant. And then he left them at the shop, hadn't he?
Aye, where he had been buying a Toblerone for someone.
Toblerone. Anyway.
The
other great customs story is when we were like, we'd been dropped off. I think we were in Russia. I'm sure it was so late. Or Poland. It was super, super late. Anyway, it doesn't matter where we were because it was the same all the time. We're always late. So we had to like literally run through the whole airport, throw our bags in. And we were carrying our small bag, you know, like with your toothpaste and whatnot in. And obviously the Russian staff like were just like confiscating everything. So like Lloyd had a brand new bottle of like £80 aftershave.
I'll tell you exactly what it was. It was Comme des Garçons, which is a lovely aftershave as well. It was 140 quid.
Oh.
And the Russian woman just looked at him, right, and she just went, "No." And he went, "Bob brought it in." So, and it's less than 100 mil. And she went, "No." And she just took it off him. And I've never seen a face like it. And the best part was when she like Michael Jordaned it into a bin about 3 meters away. And it just went. And Lloyd knew he wasn't getting it back.
I thought they were just putting them in a bin and then taking them all out when they went home.
Oh no, she Michael Jordaned it. Like, it was a pleasure. "You're you Western man with your degradance and smells that we don't like. Check it out, my man." And just lobbed it.
"Do not like this musk."
"It does not smell like potato.
Or cabbage." "There's only one aftershave in Russia and it's cabbage."
"Like Charlie Bucket wears."
Great Russian accent.
Yeah.
Malcolm Cato on drums, of course. That is the Stance Brothers. I love that record.
We haven't...
What?
The album that I've done with Max Beasley. It's Malcolm Cato on the drums on that.
Is it?
Yeah.
I thought that would have been Max himself. No, or Max's dad.
Malcolm Cato.
Not other guy from Bullseye.
And obviously, I've just let everyone into a huge secret. You know what I mean? But at the same time...
He's the greatest drummer in the world for me. Now, great. We're staying on a similar tip, on the soul tip. This is Leroy Hudson. I always call him Hudson for some reason. And this is an amazing song called I Can't Say Enough About My Mum. Mom.
Got a great song coming next. By the BW.
I've never heard her say a bad word in my life. She was nurtured by the golden rule. You just do for other people what you'd like to have them do for you. And no matter what, come hell or high water, there's gonna be someone there to see you through.
Coming up shortly, I'm going to play you something absolutely magnificent. This guy, right, co-wrote Danny Hathaway's song, The Ghetto. And he's done a version on this album, which is which was discovered by Eddie Piller. This has been reissued on Acid Jazz in 2018. I'm not even sure whether this was originally released. So there you go.
I've got some, like, crazy stuff for you later.
Exactly. Before we get to that, let's go to John's soul box.
John, what's in your soul box? What's in your soul box today?
Look at me. This is kind of obscure, right? But have you ever heard, right, of this singer called Barry White?
I've heard of Barry Black. Barry Gray.
No, Barry White, I'm talking about. You must have heard of him, man. No. He's a great singer.
No, no. Why?
He's songs? A standout like, sort of
what
guy.
What songs has he done?
Like, loads of sexy stuff.
Nah, I'm not into that stuff, like.
For the lasses and that. You know, if you're in the mood for some kind of sexy time, he's the go-to guy. Have you never heard of him?
Well, I mean, I'm supposed to be the sexy man, isn't I?
Oh, no, you're the sexy guy in Smoove and Turrell. Therefore, I'm like the most unsexual guy. That I'm basically a child.
And I'm a horse.
Yeah, yeah, you're a horse. But have you ever heard of this Barry White
oh
guy?
Oh, my God. No, I've never heard of Barry White.
Well, I'll tell you what.
What shade of white?
This is, well, supreme white.
All right, okay.
Farron Ball, probably... Masterful White by Farrow and Ball. This is a little track.
Farrow Balls.
Well, you've never heard it before, right? So okay. I tell you what, I'm going to play it, right? And you tell us if you like it.
Is this a world exclusive?
It's a world exclusive. And you tell me if you like it or you don't like it. All right. End of it, right? Are you ready?
Right, I'm ready. I definitely like it. Oh, man, I was the one that told you to play this. I couldn't find the record, to be fair. I couldn't find it. I couldn't be asked
to
find it.
You had to see it.
I know. I couldn't be asked to find the record.
It was much funnier if you had just left it.
I know. Sorry. I actually remixed this. Oh, enough about that.
Bragging.
Shut up, man. It's a tune, though.
Indeed, when you give it up, It's only enough to make me see who we that you're playing a game. It's so plain you want me to win. Girl, I'll play whatever you say. If love is the end, playing your game, baby. Your game, baby. Just you and me. Playing your game, baby. Your game, baby. Just you and me.
I was very lucky to have seen Barry White live. Now that's a brah alert. A few people online are saying they've never heard this song. Jason Smith, particularly, a good friend of mine. Yeah, yeah, amazing.
Yeah, he's never had sex.
Yeah, he's never had sex with Barry White.
Never heard this tune. Never had sex. And that's an actual, you get a certificate for it.
Barry White Virgin.
Barry White gives you a certificate if you've never heard this tune before, because it means that you've never had sex.
I sampled Barry White on a song years ago, the intro, because I was watching an interview with him. It was brilliant, his interview. He was so... Oh, what have you done, John? It was so super smooth. He was so cool in the interview. I was like, wow, the guy is like... He really is genuine. We're just saying his lyrics are they're not pastiche, they're not corny.
No, nothing
they're
about
so
it is.
Genuine.
It's like, that's what I mean. It's like... Well, Barry White, you can actually just get into everything he's saying. And not one bit do you think, oh, that's shit.
You know what I'm going to do? Yeah, next Wednesday, you know, when it's sex day, right? I'm going to put Barry White on and see if it works to the missus.
Well, you'll get a certificate if it does. Because Barry White gives you a certificate for every time it right. does as well.
But anyway, the story goes, so he's getting interviewed. And he takes a few, like, questions from people, you know, like... From whatever means it was at the time on the phone, and what one of the person
telegraph.
Said, "What was the what like? Is it wrong to have phone sex, or should I stop, or should I do it?" And he said, "If you can afford the telephone to have sex, then have it." And then the next question, right, was, "Hey Barry, what's the most unusual place that you've ever had sex?" And he was like, "I was one day I was traveling down the motorway with my lady." And I just pulled over, and right there on the hard shoulder, I just had it.
Imagine the size of the car.
Oh, imagine the car rattling around.
My favourite ever though was Vic and Bob when they had done Barry Way.
Putting the liver on the fire.
And he just
genius.
Went.
Genius.
Rub some savlin on my legs.
Right, I promised you earlier that I was going to play you this because basically Leroy Hudson co-wrote this track with Danny Hathaway, one of the greatest soul singers of all time, Danny Hathaway, I'll have you know. And in fact, we always usually end up, and we will end up in Danny Hathaway's pocket at the end of the night because I know John's going to play that live album again.
Ah, because it's the best. Does.
But anyway, Leroy Hudson, the album I played earlier, he co-wrote this
Thanks,
song.
Thanks, Dave Wild.
Exactly. He co-wrote this song, The Ghetto. This is his version called The Ghetto 1974. Check this out. Thank you, Eddie Pillar, for putting this out.
Oh,
What a great tune. I was never a massive fan of Diana Ross, but that is a great tune. Again, another one of those tracks that you'd be at the disco waiting for about 20 minutes for that song to kick in. And then the DJ would talk all over it like me. And then faded away like this. With another classic. There's a lot of versions of this, but this is the one. James Taylor Quartet. Now, a few weeks ago, we were talking about Poonanaw. We always talk about Poonanaw. Back in Leicester, remember, John?
Well, it was a part of me little crack that I had, you know.
On the podcast.
With Gareth John, you know what I mean?
It was great, great. But Poonanaw meant a lot to me because I was actually employed for three different clubs around the globe. The UK.
Yeah, you won't you won't even notice.
I was in Leicester, Lincoln, and not London.
All the big cities, yeah. And all the ones that start with L. And Leicester, Lincoln, and Leeds.
And Aberdeen.
That doesn't start with an L.
It doesn't matter. That's what ruined it. Anyway, I was working for the company, doing lots of gigs, getting paid. It was an enjoyable time. Thank you very much for everyone who gave me the work. Hats off to Mick, Stevie Strides, and Chris as well, who's always on this show, but he's on another name, not quite sure what name. Anyway, thank you very much for the work.
Skull Monkey Killer.
Yes, that's not his name. I remember going to the toilet, I'd had a few beers. The bouncer was so cool. He was like, I'll look after the gear, but don't worry. Went to the toilet and then tried to get back, and because the club's full of mirrors, I couldn't find the decks. Obviously, I was pissed out of my head. I was slightly inebriated anyway, bit of professional. And anyway, the music went off like this. It was obviously the record just ran out. Well, actually, it was doing this. It was making this noise. Like when I came back in the room, it was doing that, and everyone was stood on the dance floor, still going like this,
as if it was just part of your act.
Yeah, and I was like, hang on, that should be playing. And I was like, oh shit! I just grabbed any record that was on the floor. Pulled it out like that. Grab it. Put it on. It didn't matter. It's just get rid of the silence. And I put this on. And I'm not joking. It was one of the most life-changing things that ever happened, because I realised after this accident that you could take the night down by playing a classic record. Obviously, it wasn't intentional at the time, but I learned so much from that, and this was the record.
How this happened to be the one and only spotter from the refugee crew? So you all over the refugee crew and the drum band and the dance floor session. So we don't play with sound class. Sound like the med bag.
Any pussy dancing!
Strumming the plates with our fingers.
At this point, the whole room lit up, right? And everybody started singing. And it was like, oh my god, the bouncer just hugged me so tight, he nearly cracked half of my ribs. It was the most amazing, and it woke me up, it definitely woke me up. Sobered me up, sorry. Such a long intro as well. When the beat dropped, it was like, oh my god.
With this sound.
You request this, we want.
Drumming my pain with his fingers, singing my life with his words, killing me softly with his song, killing me softly with his song, telling my whole life with his words, killing me softly.
Yo, yeah. This is my cleft refuge.
I can still see the room going absolutely apeshit right now. Every time I hear this song.
While I'm on this roast, I got my girl.
Because they've been waiting 10 minutes for silence.
Nah, but that downtime, man.
Oh, man.
Made them realize how great music was. And that's the thing.
Happy accidents.
I want to let this play out and then I'll tell the best ever downtime that we've ever had.
For a while. And there he was, this young boy, stranger to my eyes. Killing me softly with this song, killing me softly.
I felt he found my letter, then read each one out loud. I prayed that he would finish, but he just kept right on, strumming my pain with his fingers.
Benji B just said, Bob Ross made mistakes with these trees. Funny enough, I was watching them the other day, you know. I was like trying to show my son, look, watch this, it's amazing. And then I turned around and my son was gone.
I'm sorry, bro. I've got something else happening in my life. From Mike Frisbee, one of the funniest men alive, right? I used to work with him. I used to teach them. I don't know what he taught kids, right? But he's one of the funniest men alive. All I can say is that I can't tell you what I'm talking about.
Oh, well, what's the point?
You were going to tell me. I love Mike Frisbee.
You were going to tell me another story. Remember about, before we did this, about a moment with Smoove Turrell? Or have you forgot already?
No, I'm not. Right.
You have.
We went down, right, and it was the first time that we're ever going to sort it. Well, not Smoove's first time. He had met Norman Jay a lot of times.
A lot of times.
Back in the day.
Word up.
Word up. So we're going to do this the way the song works. Smoove was just best mate with Norman, having a great time. With Norman, having a great time.
Great time.
So, we went down to Brighton to do this gig, and honestly, it was, the rain was somewhat ridiculous.
Oh, it was Brixton, man. It was Brixton.
Was it Brixton?
Is that the one where the MacBook,
where everything went down?
The MacBook just went.
That was I.
It went. And I was like, oh, John, I forgot to plug the MacBook in. It's going to take 14 minutes to boot back up. Or, well, it felt like that long, but it was only probably 14 seconds.
Yeah, because he was panicking.
I was like, John, just sing something. And then he started singing this.
Bossy play magician sitting lotus on the floor. Barely dancing ditties with their power living songs. Had my share of nightmares. I didn't think I could take much more. One in what red regards you with the lady ever know. She tied my head with the ribbon of a silky ghost of thread. Well, I gaze with double vision on that awful boast of bed. When all at once I heard some music playing in my bones. The song I heard from years before reminded me of home. But it's all right with Lady Eleanor. It's all right, Lady Eleanor. I'm all right where I stand.
And I was like, John, I still haven't powered up. Sing another one. And this went on for three or four songs. Norman stood behind us going, this guy's voice is amazing. He wasn't arsed, was he, really? I was arsed.
Ages afterwards, right? Norman Jay, no, he got in touch.
No, hang on. No, this is what happened. I'm in the airport flying to Essex, right, by myself. I think John was doing a gig somewhere else in France, and I was going to meet him in Essex or something crazy like that. One of them wild times, and when you could fly. And I walked in, and obviously Norman's in the airport now. Now he sticks out like a sore thumb in the what's it called, Flybe Airport. You know, there's like, it's like a shed, isn't it? I was like the guy with a massive hat and like, you know, cool as funk. And I went like, Norman, hello, mate. Yeah, you probably won't remember me. My name's Smoove. I'm from Smoove and Sorelli. And he went, yeah, right, mate. And then I went, let me tell you a story that might jig your memory. And I told him that story. Oh, yeah, remember. Yeah, yeah, you're the fucking idiot that pulled the power plant guy. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Love you guys. Lovely, love. Yeah, mate. All right, let's. And then that was it. And then we shared a ride. It was really funny. Lovely guy.
He did say I had one of the best voices ever. But you know what I mean. Smoove doesn't want to say that, but that's what Norman said.
Actually, the best time when we played Leicester, and he turned up, and he knew we were at that point, definitely. And he just stood and watched you smash it, like absolutely smash it. And he was just like, the smile on his face was amazing. I'll never forget that.
I can't even remember.
But then again, I was doing my job.
All right, let's keep it soulful. I love the soul. Here's another one for Benji B. Getting ruined tonight, mate. Like it's cold, brother.
Oh, heat it up. I like it when it's hot.
Words that mean so much to me.
definitely on a Smoove tip tonight, right?
Hey, man, I feel like I've got no fingerprints.
What was that? Sorry, John, I couldn't hear you for...
I feel like I've got no fingerprints. I'm that Smoove.
Just a crystal ball. Slippery when wet.
I'm made out of 110%
frozen
Irish
vodka.
Crystal.
Is that even a thing, frozen vodka?
I don't know, but it must be close to Waterford crystal.
What temperature does vodka freeze? I want to know. Is it like 100 million minus 3?
I don't know, but Tony still hasn't freezed. And it's been in my freezer for about 3 weeks.
Now, you know we're huge fans of Sunny on this show. We say that every single week. Because we don't get the sun. I found it. I found it, John. You know the one with James Brown? The one that we love? This
the
is
the greatest version yes. of Sonny that is ever.
Anyone
ever
who ever said
recorded.
James Brown couldn't sing, you know, like he was just used to scream, bollocks. Listen
bollocks.
To this. This is James Brown and D Felice Trio. Check this out.
I'm so glad you found this, man.
Flown at light speed.
It's the hour after, it's alright.
This is the way I feel. Sunny, yesterday my life was filled with the rain. Oh baby, Sunny, you smiled at me and really ease the pain.
It's magic.
Dark days are done and bright days are here. My sunny one shines so sincere. Sunny, I'm so true, one so true. I love you.
How good is
get
that, man?
In,
how
James
good is
Brown.
That? James Brown can sing. Shut up.
One of the fucking greatest singers the world's ever heard. Simple as that.
Now, here's one of my favourite albums of all time. In Flight, and this is Valdez in the Country. George Benson.
Oh, what an album.
It won't be long before we're signing out. Thank you very much, everybody, for donating all of your money that you own. For giving us your caravan, your car, and your house.
Well, it is a donation night, I must admit.
I must admit,
we've
I forgot
very
to
quiet.
Mention that.
We've been very quiet on that front.
Give me your money!
I prefer to be English. We have been very quiet on that point, but
I was saying that. I don't know who that was. I think that was Johnny Gargo.
Johnny Gargo's much more American. Disgraceful.
Agree, that is an incredible album, and if you haven't got the album, then you should get it now. In Flight, George Benson. Everyone goes on about George Benson Breezing, but for me, In Flight is the best album ever made by him because it's got In the Ghetto on, which is not the Danny Hathaway song.
It's not my favourite George Benson album.
Oh, it's so good, that album. Honestly, it's
not,
so good.
But I totally agree with you that every song on it is beautiful.
Actually, I love
but
George.
It's not my
I love the
George
best
Benson
of George Benson, Benson. Love Times Love. Love Times Love! And it's always there for us to share. And it sure feels good.
I never said that was my favourite album of George Benson. Not once.
I'm feeling my dub at the minute. I don't know what's going on, but this is what I'm feeling right now. I think we're going to sign off very soon. Probably play one more from John if you want one.
Thank God for that.
Oh, thank you very much. Tickets, please. I've actually got a funny story. You know, like, we
set the record player, man.
No, I want to tell you.
Stories aren't that funny.
I want to tell you the story. It's really funny.
All right.
I got on the train with Foss once, right? Went to Leeds for a night out.
Oh, it's got Foss in it.
It's brilliant. Got on the train to Leeds. Didn't buy a ticket. Thought would like risk it, like be a bit woo. Anyway, obviously the ticket inspector collared us. And Foss just went, "How? Bugger off." Well, he just stood there looking at him. Then we stood up and like walked further on. And then Foss said, obviously by this point we're half pissed. Foss went, "Get in the bike rack thing and pretend your luggage." This is how pissed we were. And we sat there like squares like this. Like, and the guy walked past us and stood and looked at us. And we were thinking, we look like luggage. And he walked past.
I'm sure that wasn't just drink.
He just gave up. He just went, "You know what? They're clearly luggage." Anyway, it gets better, it gets better. We got off the train, right? We actually made it out without paying. And then
made it out. Ladies were escaping Alcatraz.
And then when you get a lead, there's like this barrier that you can't get through. It's like a brick wall with like loads of like you need your car to get out, you know, that kind of. They were the first people to do it.
Just jump that lead.
Well, no, we had to jump this wall with all this grease and pigeon shit on. So got over that, right? Got to the club and it was shut and we couldn't get in and then we couldn't. Anyway, we spent the whole night in McDonald's. That was it. Then we couldn't get the last train home, so we had to sleep on the train station floor.
This just sounds like
it was
cool
the
times.
Worst night out in my life. It really was.
Just cool times.
Bad times. I mean, I'm sure if I spoke to Foss, he would go, "I can't remember that." Like, no, because you've blanked it out your memory. That's why.
Foss would actually tell you that he can remember it though. That's what's good about the kid.
Foss was at my stag do, actually. That's the one thing I remember.
I wasn't.
You were doing a gig.
Couldn't be arsed.
You and Mike were doing the big chill.
Yeah, we were.
Yeah, and you were. Yeah, let's not talk about that.
Having the fun in that.
Oh, too
Don't
much fun.
Talk
yeah.
about that.
When Smoove's not there, this is when I realised very quickly.
When Smoove's not there,
I need to be there.
Tits up.
Totally tits up. TTT. Anyway, John, what you got to play for your last song?
I love Cracking Smack.
We all do.
One of the greatest in our mates, but also the music. Sometimes, for this thing especially, was just a throwaway song. But I love it. And this is called Hotel Cerezo.
I've got to give a big shout to Julie Teasdale and Mark Teasdale, of course.
They're just belter people.
They are like. And Mary, happy 40th birthday.
Maria, man.
I know exactly. You bastard. Well, thank you very much, folks. We've really enjoyed it, and we really look forward to next week, which I'm sure will come round in 3 minutes.
I'm not being funny, but I'm taking next week off.
Are you now?
I am just going to make cakes. Not
the Great British Kids Bake Off.
Aye. Me and Harry Hill.
I tell you what, I love watching that. Like, my missus
me
hates
and Harry Hill. I love it. Harry Hill.
I absolutely love Harry Hill.
I love Harry Hill.
He was window licking the day. I was like, you can't do that in front of kids.
Harry Hill is one of the greatest comedians of all time.
Apparently.
Can I tell you,
someone
right?
saw
this
him.
Is no shit. Right. Me and Nicola, right? We had smoked some serious blunts that night, right? It was me, Nicola, I think Dickie, and my mate Jay. And I had bought tickets for them too, because they didn't even know who he was. And we got wrecked. And then we turned up at the theatre. I don't think it was... It was the... not the theatre, right? It was the other one, right? Or was that Stone? I can't remember. And I swear to God, it was the funniest thing I've ever seen. Harry Hill came on stage. And he just rocked it.
You know what I love about Harry Hill, right? Apparently somebody saw him on the tube and he had the same gear on. Like the big collars, the black black.
He just
coat.
Wears it. He
is the character that he is all the time, apparently.
And the fact that he is a trained doctor, you know, like...
A doctor of what?
Save your life. No, he's actually a doctor. As in, you know, like a really highly classified doctor. He can save your life in an instant. No shit.
On that note, we're going to say goodnight. And now I've got an idea. I don't know if it's going to work, because I love a good theme, me. Don't I, John? A theme.
He loves a theme.
The theme of this week is End the Show.
Just hung up the telephone. I've heard all about you. Your new boyfriend couldn't wait to tell me that you and I are through. Don't try to spare my feelings, just get out.
Fuck off.
Just fuck off.
Get out.
I don't know where or when. I know I love I'm gonna again. Love again. It's so hard for you.
It's so hard for
and
you.
I'll tell you what
but
you
know what you gotta
you
do.
Get out.
Get out. Get out. Get out. Get out, girl.
Get out.
Oh, oh, oh,
get out.
Oh, oh, oh. I better get out, baby.
What a tune, man. Amazing. Thank you very much, everyone, and good night, and get out.
And let me cry.
If you're gay, get out.
Get out,
if
man.
If you're straight, get out. If you're noisy, get out.
If you're quiet, get out.
Simple as that.